Good morning, children. Now I am going to take English for you. So, if you have English textbook, please open your English textbook. Please take your English textbook and open page number 71. Okay, children. Page number 71, unit 9. So, here the lesson name is Dr. Kotnis. Okay, children. So before studying that lesson, here they are given some pictures about a map. Let us know our neighbors. Look at a map and write the names of our neighboring countries. Your teacher will help you. So I have written some of our neighboring countries' name. Here this is China, Pakistan, Nepal, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Myanmar. So, 6 neighboring countries I have written the names. Okay, children. So, you also copy in your textbook. So, how should we be with our neighbors? So, how you must be with our neighbors means we must help for our neighbors. We must talk to them politely and we must help one another. Our neighbors, and we must be helpful to our neighbors. Now let us study about Dr. Kotnis. So that is the name of a person. So I'm going to read the lesson. Listen carefully. We all remember great men and women born in our country. Very rarely are people remembered in other countries. Here is a story of one great Indian who is remembered and respected in China for his service even today. So there are so many great men and women, they are born in our country. You know, children, in other countries only some persons are there, but in our country, but in India, there are so many persons, great men and women, who was born in our country. So they have done so many things for us. So one of the great Indian is respected in China, and today also we remember about that man. So there is a story about that man who was respected in China for his service. Dwarakanath Shantaram Kotnis was born on 10th October 1910 in Solapur, Canada. So this man named Dwarakanath Shantaram Kotnis. So he was born on 10th October 1910. So in which country? In Solapur, a Kannada speaking area in Maharashtra. So he was born in Maharashtra. In that area, they were speaking Kannada. Okay, children. After his matriculation, he wanted to become a doctor and serve people. But his family was not in a position to bear the expenses for his medical education. With a lot of hard work and help from others, he was able to pursue his dreams. His determination to study medicine and help the needy brought him success. He studied Bachelor of Medicine at GS Medical College of the University of Mumbai. So, what is his name? His name Dwarakanath Shantaram Kotnis. He was born in 10th October 1910 in Solapur, in a Kannada speaking area in Maharashtra. So after his matriculation, he wanted to become a doctor and he wanted to serve people. But his family was poor and they could not bear the expenses for his medical education. So he took help from others and he was pursued his dreams. So his determination was to study about medicine and to help the needy people and to help the poor people. So with the help of others, he studied Bachelor of Medicine. In which college? In GS Medical College in the University of Mumbai. So with the help of others, he studied Bachelor of Medicine. So in which college? In GS Medical College. So where the medical college was there? In Mumbai. He studied there with the help of other people. There was a war between China and Japan in 1937. Many Chinese soldiers were injured. China requested India to send doctors to treat the injured soldiers. Dr. Kotnis was one among the five Indian doctors who went to China. Only Dr. Kotnis remained there when the others returned to India. He used an ambulance as a mobile clinic to treat the wounded soldiers. So, after he studied his medical college, he was working as a doctor. There was a war between whom? Between China and Japan. So in which year? In 1937. So many Chinese soldiers were injured, and that China country, they requested for India to send some doctors to treat the wounded soldiers. So in India, five doctors went for China. In that five doctors, one doctor was Dr. Kotnis. So the five doctors went to China to treat the injured soldiers. So in that, only Dr. Kotnis remained there only in China country, and other four doctors, they returned to India. So what this Kotnis doctor done? He used an ambulance as a mobile clinic to treat the wounded soldiers. So there was no hospital there. So what he done? He used an ambulance as a clinic, mobile clinic, and he treated the wounded soldiers, injured soldiers inside the ambulance only. Next, there were times when he carried the wounded soldiers on his shoulders. Once he happened to work for 72 hours continuously without rest or sleep. The hardships of military life and stress made him weak. He died of epilepsy in 1942 at a very young age of 32. His body was buried in the courtyard of heroes. The president of China mourned the death of Kotnis by observing that the army has lost a helping hand. The nation has lost a friend. Let us always bear in mind his international spirit. So, when he was doing this work, several times he carried the wounded soldiers on his shoulders. So, one day, he worked for 72 hours. So, 60 hours make one day. So, 72 hours means more than 1.5 days. So, he worked without sleeping and without taking rest, without taking food. He worked like that. So, what it meant for his body means without stress, that life, military life, it made the body weak, and he died of epilepsy. So epilepsy means a condition affecting the brain that can, so suddenly they'll become unconscious and they can't control their movements for a short time. So that is called epilepsy. So he died of that epilepsy, means a disease, in 1942, in the age of 32. He died of a disease. The disease was epilepsy. So, and his body was buried in the courtyard of heroes. In China, president was there, no? Say, they mourned the death of Kotnis by saying that they lost their helping hand. The army had lost a helping hand, and the nation has lost a friend. So, Dr. Kotnis, no? He helped so much for Chinese people, and he was most friend for Chinese. So today also they will remember, and they will keep in the mind as a international spirit. Next, even today Dr. Kotnis is revered by the Chinese. In April 2005, on the occasion of the ancestors commemoration day, flowers were sent to statue of Dr. Kotnis from all parts of China, even by school children. The story of his life was a subject of Hindi film Dr. Kotnis Ki Amar Kahani, directed by V. Shantaram, who was a Kannadiga. Any Chinese top level delegation to India never misses to honor the family of Dr. Kotnis. The gratitude of Chinese towards him is highly remarkable. So even today, this Dr. Kotnis, he died of epilepsy, no? He was given respect, or someone they would admire very much, so by the Chinese. So in April 2005, on the occasion of Ancestors Commemoration Day, means a day in the past that makes you remember and respect someone or something important. So that important day, the flowers were sent for the statue. They made a statue of Dr. Kotnis and wrote his name. And for that statue, the flowers were sent from all parts of the China, and even by school children, they sent flowers and they were put on the statue of Dr. Kotnis. So that day we will remember as Ancestors Commemoration Day. Okay, children. So the story of his life, what he has done in his life, that all they were taken as a film. So that was a Hindi film. So the Hindi film name was Dr. Kotnis Ki Amar Kahani. So this film was directed by V. Shantaraman. So he was a Kannadiga. So they have taken the Dr. Kotnis as a, his life history, they have taken as a picture. So that picture name was, that is a Hindi picture. So that picture name was Dr. Kotnis Ki Amar Kahani. So even today in Chinese, they said their delegation, they said they will be in a group of people and they represent a country, and they sent to India, they won't never miss to honor the family of Dr. Kotnis. They will be in a group and they will honor the family of Dr. Kotnis. The gratitude of Chinese towards him is highly remarkable. So even today, they give respect for the Kotnis family. So they will give a surprising which gets praised even today. So it is a remarkable day. So which is that remarkable day? Means Ancestors Commemoration Day. That statue, even today it is a remarkable for Chinese. Okay, children. Next. See here in page number 75, they are given some words. Find at least 10 words related to sickness from the grid. So I have marked in the black pen. So you also mark in your textbook. So first is medicine, nurse, treatment, emergency, doctor, patient, sick, hospital, needle, ambulance. Okay, children. So these are the 10 words related to the sickness. Okay, children. Any doubt, children? I think you could have understood this lesson. Shall I ask some question, children? So when was Dwarkanath Kotnis born, children? Can anyone say? So he was born on 10th October 1910 in Solapur, a Kannada speaking area in Maharashtra. Second, where did he study his medicine, children? He studies his medicine in GS Medical College in the University of Mumbai. Next, who invaded China in 1937, children? So Japan invaded China in 1937. Fourth, how old was Dr. Kotnis when he went to China? So, Dr. Kotnis was 32 years when he went to China. Next, where was his body buried? So, his body was buried in the courtyard of heroes. Next, name the movie directed by V. Shantaraman and the life of Dr. Kotnis. So, the movie name is Dr. Kotnis Ki Amar Kahani. Okay, children. I think you could have understood this lesson. So, I am giving notes also. So, please write the notes in the classwork neatly. Okay, children. Thank you, children.